It'd be rather nasty if the governor found out you'd been hanging around with criminals and ex-prison officers.
You'd better not be the one to tell her.
Why not? What have I got to lose? I've got you to thank for being here.
Anne, I didn't know.
If you're so stupid, you can't see what'd be obvious to anybody else.
If I'd realised, I'd never have got involved with you and George.
No, you probably wouldn't either. We give you a chance to get something out of your life and you pass it up.
Why is P so interested in Yates?
Well, she used to bring things for the girls and they used to reckon that she brought drugs in. She was here when Sally died. You remember Sally, don't you?
Yeah, my first day.
Well, B hates pushers. And God help Yates if B finds out for sure that she was the one that brought them in.
Have you heard about Susan Rice? She was in court today.
Yes. She's been released on a good behaviour bond.
But the judge didn't recommend psychiatric treatment?
No.
Well, she certainly won't stay out of trouble without it. She'll be back in here again for sure. I wonder if I should get in touch with her GP, have a word with him. What do you think?
I'm sorry.
What is it?
It's Yates' personal file. It's missing.
Get rid of this.
What is it?
Just something we don't want everyone to see. Get rid of it. Bury it in a garden.
Yes, Steve, what happened? Uh-huh. Well, that is wonderful, isn't it? I hope you're proud of yourself. I just know what this is going to do to her, that's all. Only doing your job. That line has its usual sinister ring to it, Steve. Thank you for telling me. Goodbye.
Do to whom? Well, on the phone, Steve Wilson. You just said, I know what this is
Susan
going to do.
Susan Rice. Wilson was ringing from the court. The pre-trial hearing was this afternoon. The judge granted interim custody of the Rice's kids to their father.
Oh, dear. Today of all days.
Mm-hmm. In one court this morning for shoplifting and then straight out into another to have her kids taken away from her. Not only convenient, but an absolute gift for Frederick Rice and Wilson.
Well, we thought this might happen.
Yeah, I know.
Right, are we going?
Look, could you find your own way home this afternoon? I want to get over to Susan's mother. I guess that's where she'll be. God knows what sort of state she'll be in.
Jane, what are you going to do? I mean, I know
it's terrible,
but
it's none of my business,
really.
Strictly speaking. No, it isn't. But I know how she'll be. And I can't just go home and put my feet up and say, oh, well. I'm not as philosophical as our friend Mr. Wilson. Not yet.
But she's got her mother.
Yes, and I've met her. Besides, I'm just a natural meddler. Aren't I supposed to do something tonight?
Oh, yes, yes. It's a Greg Miller, a Dr. Greg Miller, I believe, we have a date.
Listen, would you mind phoning him? He'll understand. Thanks. See you later.
Okay.
Oh, Miss Bennett?
Yes?
I want to ask you something.
Hey, it talks. Thought it would go woof, woof. You two get on your way, or I'll give you some way to go.
They're on to me.
They've been on to you since...
No, they know why I'm here. B. Smith knows for sure.
Oh, my God.
She's had my file. You know what she's like.
Yes, I know. Maybe she knew all along. Now she's sure. The dinner bell.
Now what?
Go to the dining room like everyone else.
Who's on dinner duty?
I am.
You want to calm down, B? You're going to hurt yourself.
It's not me that's going to get hurt.
She'll have every screw in the joint looking out for her, so there's no point in getting stirred up.
Whose side are you on?
Yours, B. Yours. What do you think I am?
I don't know.
Oh, hang on. You know we're both with you.
Well, you bloody well better be, because if you're not, you're on the side of the screws, and worse than screws.
Oh, okay.
G'day, Eula.
Hi. Hello, Monty.
Yeah, what are you doing hanging around out here? When the bell's gone.
We heard it. What's got into sour pussy?
You know we were talking about why Yates might be in here.
Yeah, we had a few ideas.
Yeah, well, now we know.
Drugs!
Oh, I see.
We don't like that, do we, B?
You're darn right we don't. We get very annoyed.
Well, she went straight to Bennett.
Oh, now is that right?
Yeah. And it looks like Bennett's going to bring her in now.
And here they come.
That's a bit of a mongrel to me.
Well, I say you can't teach an old one new tricks.
What are you lot waiting for? The head waiter? Now get inside.
Very nice of you to take an interest in one of the new girls, Miss Bennett.
What's that supposed to mean?
Escorting Yates here to dinner.
Yeah, she might have took the wrong way.
I said inside. You too, Yates.
Oh, now. No need to snap at Yatesy. She knows the rules. Don't you, Yatesy?
I ought to.
Yeah.
Go on.
You sit down, Bea. I'll get yours.
Get your meal, Yates.
Smells like dog food. Don't sit there. That's Wonky Warner's seat.
She could be here at any moment.
Yeah, so shove off.
Hey, Angie. Come and sit over here, love. There's a dirty little chocolate frog gonna spring on you.
What do you want to do with her, Ben?
I know what I'd like to do to her.
Yeah, but it's going a bit far, don't you reckon?
She'll be something real slow.
She one of the mob got your daughter hooked?
Well, how would I know? And who cares anyway? They're all the same. Just turn over the nearest rock and there they are.
Oh, geez, we had a salt on this table.
Where are you off to, Smith?
To get some salt. Oh, hey. Mind if I borrow your salt?
You have a lot to answer for, Pusher. This is just a start.
Oh, look, I'm that sorry.
I saw that, Smith. How pathetic.
Oh, well, I could do better.
Get back to your table.
Do you hear that?
No.
She threatened me directly.
Just get yourself another meal.
Mrs. Henrys, I heard about the court's decision today. I was wondering if there's anything I could do.
It's very good of you. But if you mean Susan, she's gone off somewhere. I'm here all by myself.
What, the children have gone already?
He might have waited. I think it's vicious. That Frederick sent one of his people over in the car and they took him off just like little objects.
How's Susan taking it?
I don't know. I mean, won't you come?
Oh, no, thank you, Mrs. Henrys. I don't want to be of any trouble. Have you any idea where Susan may have gone?
No, none. I think I'm out of my depth, Miss Vernon, really, I do. When we came home from the court, Susan was chattering as if nothing had happened. As if she'd won, it was all over and she'd won. And then this man came in the car and the children were crying and well, there was quite a scene. That man that Frederick sent was some sort of a hippie or something.
Well, why didn't Mr. Rice come himself?
Well, there was this television thing tonight.
And he had to be there?
Well, yes, naturally.
Yes, well, naturally. Do you think Susan may have gone there to the TV station?
Well, I don't know. She didn't say. She just left. After all that screaming and banging, I went out to make a cup of tea. And she must have just slipped out. I just hope to goodness she's all right.
But it's a film about Robert Taylor. Who's Hank?
Oh, you must know Robert Taylor. Why, when I was a girl, I went every single thing.
Well, you must have seen it 10 times already. I'm watching Jason Richards.
Like hell you are.
Oh, yes, I am.
Come on, Smith.
You screws really stick together, don't you?
On your way.
Do you know what she's in here for?
Of course. But how did you find out? This is just going to go on and on. They're not going to let up.
What do you expect me to do?
Jump on the bitches. You used to be good at that. What's wrong with you? Smith's round the twist. She's going to have a go at me, and she's got every one of them on side.
I know, I know.
If anything happens to me, Vera, quite a few people are going to be very sorry.
What do you mean?
Oh, don't play cutesy pie, you know. You get me something, a knife, anything, so at least I can stand up to them.
Are you crazy? I can't do that. Look, nothing's going to happen to you. The officers will be looking out for you. Well, you're a prisoner here, and that's their job.
Oh, who are you trying to kid? I've worked here, remember? Oh,
God almighty, Anne, you got yourself in here.
And you're supposed to look after me. So far, you look bloody useless.
Look, shut up. Let me think.
This is ridiculous.
Got a better idea?
I might as well be in the pound.
That can be arranged. You're safe, aren't you? So stop bleating. What did you do with that file?
It's here. Just a minute. What are you going to do with it?
Put it back where it belongs.
It's been stolen. I'm returning it. You can get Smith for being in possession of stolen property. Dump her in the pound.
Yeah? And who lagged on Smith? You did. They're already calling you a dog. Just use your head.
Oh, right. By the way, how's George?
I wouldn't know. He's left town.
Oh, he'll be back. He likes you.
Does he?
Jason Richards is on TV tonight, and I'm watching it. Well, you don't own the telly set.
I'm going to take a vote. Hands up, all those for Robert Taylor.
Jason Richards. You lose.
Oh, it's not fair.
It is so fair, and if you don't like it, rack off. Yay, Jason Richards!
Oh, shut up, will you, Doreen? Who gives a stuff about what's on TV?
Oh, Monty, you should see him. He's fantastic.
She told him to shut up. Well, let's carry on about some fish-eyed poofter. Useless, a lot of them.
Hey, B.
Well?
Vinegar Tits has locked her little bitch away for the night.
Oh, has she now? Well, she'll keep. She still has to eat and wash and go to the can. I'll get her.
Yeah, be sure.
Just thinking about her,
well,
mate.
You can all relax. I'm going off duty now.
Oh, we'll miss you.
It was real nice of you, Miss Bennett, doing the right thing by Miss Yates.
What?
Tucking her into bed. I mean, she did look peaky. We was all worried about her.
She wouldn't be up to this kind of life, poor thing.
Oh, no, seen better days, I'd say.
You all think you're very clever, don't you?
We've all got eyes, if that's what you mean. And we can all see one dirty, filthy, stinking, rotten drug pusher who used to be a screw being treated real nice.
Yeah, how come, Miss Bennett? I mean, usually you kind of stand back with a smile on your face and just watch us bash the daylights out of one another.
Just watch yourself, Ferguson.
Only asking.
Oh, fair go, girls. There's probably more in this than meets the eye.
What are you doing in here, Birdsworth? Haven't you been denied all privileges? Now get to your cell.
Well, I've always wondered how low Vinegar Tits would stoop. Now we all know.
And we'll be right back with our very special guest, Jason Richards.
Anne, hey, thought you'd be away for hours. How'd you get on?
Third day.
She wasn't there.
Money,
what's she?
One of those tonight shows. Jason Richards is going to be on.
Great.
Thought I'd have a look at him.
I spoke to the mother. Apparently Frederick Rice didn't waste a second whisking the kids away.
Please welcome Jason Richards.
That's Susan, isn't it?
Where?
There. Oh, she's gone again.
They seem to like you. The Ben would I be here if they didn't?
Smug bastard.
Well, you're certainly on the crest of a wave right now, Jason.
Yes.
Your album taking
I'm
you there
sure
is right
I
up
saw
there,
Susan
on the way
in
to a doll.
We're
very proud.
You know, I had a feeling. She really hates this guy.
We're hoping that you're going to sing for us a little later.
I wonder perhaps why she was there.
I thought you'd never ask.
Don't know.
I hear you're off to the States very soon.
That now ranks as the worst kept secret in the business. Yes, Ben, we're going to try and crack it, OS.
You'll be taking your whole team?
Can't move without them. A great bunch of people. I really mean that, Ben. My manager, the roadies, the secretaries, they all work their bums off for me. Sorry, Ben. But that's the business, and I know I love them for it.
Sure.
Yeah, it's been tough. We've been on the road off and on for a couple of years now.
That can't leave much time for any family life.
Sure, sure. There are broken hearts behind the glamour, Ben. But you make your choices in this life, and you've got to live with it.
No regrets, then.
Oh, man. I mean, well, what's the point, you know? I mean, the Almighty gives you talent, and what are you going to do?
You're a religious man, Jason.
I've taken Jesus into my heart, Ben. I'm not ashamed to admit that.
But you've always had the reputation of being something of a hellraiser.
Yes, I know. I'll tell you something, Ben, and this is a true story. It happened to be one night when I was on tour.
Oh, God! Oh, God! What is this? Oh, God! Oh, God! This is a cure.
Oh, my God. Is it? I guess so. I never thought you'd go so far as that. Why didn't anybody listen to me? Strike right. Bloody Susan, she's off her rocker. Stay tuned,
please. Meanwhile, some music. Looks, eh?
The old acid trick.
He needed something the way he was going on the slurry bus.
But how could she do that to Jason Richards?
You'll be able to ask her tomorrow, Doreen. She'll be back here now, no worries. Here on the loony bin.
Oh, that rotten bitch.
Frighten you. Pleased to see me?
Oh, of course I am. But you said last time we shouldn't be seen together. Is everything all right?
Of course everything's all right. Just not over, that's all. I got lonely. I missed you.
I missed you too.
What's all this? You deserve better than that. Junk food.
Oh, it's all right.
We'll make do with it for tonight. But from now on, my girl, it's nothing but the best for you. Sit down, I'll get you a drink. How's Anne?
You and your precious Anne. You know, you've put me in an impossible position at work. She's stupid enough to get herself put inside, and all she does is whine to me about protection. I tell you, the way things are at the moment, she'll be damned lucky to get out of there alive.
Come on, I know things are difficult for you, but I thought she was good to them in there.
Well, that's just the point. She was good to anyone who wanted drugs smuggled in. One of the girls committed suicide because of it.
Yeah, well, the way I heard that, some bitch of a wardress locked the kid up in solitary as a punishment. The kid couldn't take it. Anyway, it's all ancient history now. Why would they bring it up?
Oh, there's this woman inside. Her daughter died from an overdose. Well, she blames it on the pushers. She really hates them. Somehow, she's got hold of Anne's personal file. She knows what Anne's in for. If she's made up her mind to get her, then she probably will. And there's nothing I can do about it.
Well, there must be something. I mean, put her on her own. Send her somewhere else.
Oh, you don't know what it's like in there. I can't watch her day and night. And these women, they're just animals.
They wouldn't go that far, would they? I mean, they wouldn't just kill her.
This one would. What's she got to lose? That's what she's in for now. Murder.
Your friends can't watch you all the time.
baking?
Oh, all right, all right.
Down to the shower block, Yates.
I don't want a shower. I'll stay here.
Unless you're sick, you'll shower and report to muster the same as everybody else.
Oh, will I?
You can bet on that.
Has Bennett come in yet?
Miss Bennett to you.
Yeah.
Now, I don't care whether you used to be employed here or not. That's your problem.
And yours, the way the women are carrying on.
Move. Are you two waiting for a tram or what? Get going.
You know, I had this little dog once.
Yeah?
Filthy little beast.
Yeah.
Always tracking its dirty.
Oh, yeah.
Finally, we just had to get rid of it.
Just shut up and make it snappy.
Yes, Mrs. Jackson.
Oh, damn, where'd I put my purse? I'm late.
That's my fault.
Yes, now I've got to go. Don't do this to me. I'm late.
Who cares?
Well, someone might come and find out why.
Why would they? Unless, of course, Annie Yates said something. You will keep an eye on her, won't you?
Bastard. You keep the door locked.
I thought old Bennett was supposed to be on in here today.
Yeah, as far as I know.
A little friend looks a bit nervous.
Yeah.
Anyone for another cuppa?
No, I'm not.
Oh! Jesus! What's going on, Ferguson?
You saw that! Do
she
something!
She raised her hand. You stop that, Smith, and get back to your seat.
You better watch yourself.
I won't warn you again, Smith.
Are you going to stop this or
shut
not?
Shut up, Jakes! All right. You heard the bell. Now get to work. The lot of you! I know how you feel, Smith, but any more of this and you'll end up in solitary.
That includes you too, Ferguson.
A pair of you. Get out. It's pretty damn obvious, isn't it? Where have you been?
I was down there. Yes?
Everybody out, Yates. Your little friend isn't too popular.
Don't start that again, Meg. She's no friend of mine.
Good morning, Mrs. Davidson.
Lynn? Off to work?
Yes.
How are you getting on?
Oh, fine, thanks. Everything's going to be okay now.
Good. Let's hope so. Well, you'd better be on your way.
Goodbye.
Doctors at Royal Melbourne Hospital said last night that although the singer's condition is satisfactory, he will probably lose the use of his left eye and extensive plastic surgery will be required. Richard suffered third-degree burns after sulfuric acid was thrown in his face during a television interview. Police have not released the name of the woman who is alleged to have thrown the acid. Richard's manager, Mr. Rip Fife, said he was profoundly shocked by the incident.
Huh?
Oh, no need to hear any more. Police have not yet released the name. No need to. We know who did it.
Yeah, but I wanted to hear the rest of it.
Oh, shut up, Doreen. Who cares?
I do. And millions of people. He was a star.
Got a few craters in him now.
Yeah, well, if I ever see that Susan Rice again, I'm going to do her honest.
Well, you'll have your chance then. Word is they brought her in during the night. Completely round the twist, they say. She's down in solitary.
Yeah, well, serve her bloody well right.
Even Jason was a nice person once upon a time.
Lad's always himself. Thinking about himself. Talking about himself. All he ever saw was mirrors. Everyone around him had to be a mirror for Jason. Frederick was his best mirror. Won't see such a pretty face now.
You hurt him very bad.
I meant to. I put a stop to him. Let's see the girl screaming now. He'll be simply hideous. No eyes to love himself with. Well, Frederick will be a bit upset. They were very close, you know. But the children and I will fix up all that. We'll go away somewhere. Just the four of us. Somewhere nice and quiet.
Susan, you're in prison.
Don't touch me, please. Prison? It's just maybe. You never can tell.
Hello, Susan.
Make yourself at home. I've got to start packing soon. Well, Frederick's coming with the children.
Yes. I've bought you some breakfast.
I'm really hungry. I've got a long, long journey.
Thought you ought to see this.
Jason Richards was granted custody today of his two children. And his real name, Frederick Rice. They're the same. Mm-hmm.
Is that this morning's paper? Well, Jason should be in there. He had a bad, bad accident last night.
I just can't understand it. Why didn't anybody tell us Jason Richards was a husband?
Nobody knew. Apparently, they got married very young, before he became famous and his career wasn't going so well. He thought it was because he had a wife and children that ruined his image. So he changed his name and pretended he was single. It's all there in that article.
No wonder she was confused. He was leading a double life. And eventually she saw him as two different people. I knew something was wrong. And I knew something like this was going to happen. But nobody would listen. Nobody would do anything.
What could anybody do? You can't just lock people away because someone else thinks they've got a mental disorder. I mean, who knows where it would end?
Well, where has it ended? What happens now? We can't just leave her in there.
Oh, no, they're sending over a couple of psychiatrists to examine her. She'll probably end up in a mental home.
This all could have been avoided.
Who knows?
Of course, you know, Lynn, most of these will die when they leave here. The mugs buy them, take them away, and that's the end.
It just seems such a waste after all our work.
Oh, well. Tell me, did Dad ever talk about me?
Oh, well, not really. He doesn't say anything much about the war, Mr. Butterfield.
No, don't blame him. He was my sergeant, you know. Like Mum and Dad and a couple of uncles thrown into our blokes, he was. Ah, yeah. There was no funny business in our platoon, but many of the boys got into strife. He was there like a shot. He's a good bloke, your dad. One of the best. Oh, I was at the wedding, you know, when he married your mum. You'd be a bit young to remember that, though. She's a bottler, your mum. Pity she's not well.
Oh, please, don't try and make me feel bad, Mr. Butterfield. I've had enough of that. Everything's going to be okay from now on.
Well, of course it is. No doubt about it. Look, Lynn, you can still make your mum and dad proud of you if you're only prepared to make the effort.
Oh, I know. It's just that, well, I'd really like to do something for myself for a change. I mean, on my own, just knowing I was right.
Oh, yeah?
No, it's just that I don't want to be mum and dad's good little girl anymore.
Eh?
Well, I don't want to be bad either. It's just that I'm so sick of being so, I don't know.
Oh, well, look, don't you worry, Lynn. I get your drift. Well, what do you know? We got a customer. You go, will you, Lynn? You'll find the key to the till under the teapot.
Well, go on.
Earn your keep.
Oh, right.
This isn't my idea of a good time.
Too bad. Would you prefer the laundry?
Vera, would you like to go and get a cup of tea?
Oh, thanks, Meg.
That's the best place for her. I heard you had to lock her in early last night.
Who told you?
Well, one of the girls asked me about it.
Oh, those smart bitches. Well, you saw what happened to breakfast. Dinner last night was the same.
It's bound to happen. I mean, we could have her transferred to another wing.
It'd be the same. Anyway, that's admitting we can't handle it. We've got the authority. I'm not having Smith and her crew push us around.
The governor wants you.
What for?
Well, ask her.
All right. Meg.
Yes, I'll watch her.
Well, Vera's really looking after Yatesy, eh?
And some of the girls have threatened her.
I'll bet they have. Well, being an ex-crew, you know. It's just that Vera usually reckons our girls ought to sort out their own problems. Sort of survival of the fittest. Well, takes the weight off our backs as well, eh?
Go on.
Well, look, you ask her. Maybe Vera's a friend of Yatesy's on the outside?
I think Vera's just doing her job.
Well, that's not what they're saying in the staff room.
I have to go to the loo.
Okay, hurry up.
Everybody ought to be back at work by now.
And where was it?
Oh, I was lying around. Birdsworth took it when she was in here, you know.
Yes, well, we'll deal with that in due course. I suppose B. Smith has seen it.
She may have.
Well, of course she has. Who else would have underlined the charge here? You know as well as I do what her reaction would be.
Well, whatever happens, we're going to handle it. But I don't know why we ever put a former officer in with those women. Oh, I mean, there have already been a few incidents.
Hmm. I would have thought Yates was regarded as the prisoner's friend.
Oh, she was an officer, and that's as far as it goes. B. Smith will beat her up if she gets the chance, and the rest will back her up, partly because Smith's a tough number, and partly because the rest would love to get their own back on a screw, any screw.
Do they hate us so much, Miss Bennet?
They're here to be punished. That's the whole idea. Oh, we could run around waiting on them hand and foot, but it wouldn't make any difference. As long as there's bars, wires and locks, this is a prison.
I'm not going to argue with you, Miss Bennet.
I don't know what you could say. May I go?
Yes, and keep me informed of any new developments.
Of course.
I thought you went to the loo.
I did, and then I came in here.
Now, get back to the garden.
Why can't you lock me in here?
Not during the day, no.
What the hell difference does it make?
Because you're going to be treated exactly the same as any other prisoner. That's what you are, you know.
Good old Maggie. You haven't changed, have you? By the book and fair's fair and all that tired old crap. You're having a ball, I suppose. You're a sadist. You want to see me crawl, do you? Well, I won't. And when I've got a knife in my back, you'll be really pleased. Well, at least I was fair, you can say.
All right. Let's see the governor.
Davidson? What good's that going to do? Well, she put me in here.
Well, perhaps she'll put you in another wing. Or solitary. Or perhaps another jail, which would suit me fine.
I'm stuck in here. I just want to live through it, that's all.
Yes, sure. Let's go.
Come, eh?
Well, it has for you, you dirty little pusher.
Watch the corridor, Molly. Where are the others?
Well, they're down in the kitchen. Someone's broken down with the washing machines or something.
Need help, do you?
Not with you, I don't.
Look, I think you've got this all wrong,
Bill.
It wasn't my fault that Sally died.
Of course it
was. Well, it was just a job to me.
Sure.
I needed the money.
You know, trouble with you a lot. Yates, they won. Oh, you want to play?
Need any help, Bill?
I'll play.
No, it's all right. Just keep watching. This rat's just throwing showing its teeth, that's all.
Come any closer, you're going to get bit.
Really? You're a real little spitfire, aren't you?
Officer Barry's assistant, Smith and Ferguson must have grabbed her.
We'll never find out unless we find Yates.
From what you say and from what Miss Bennett told me earlier, it's fairly clear. I'm afraid I made a serious mistake in trying to, in imagining, we could handle the situation.
Look, that's all very well. But can I remind you that Anne Yates is still missing? Now, I've had all uniform staff and some of the professional staff looking and we haven't found anything.
But all that can be done is being done. What about B. Smith?
Dr. Miller said he'd phone from the hospital as soon as there was any word.
We'd better have an officer posted at the hospital. Better still, arrange for a policewoman.
Now, can I go back to my duties, Mrs. Davidson? We've got to find that woman. She might be dead.
Please stay calm, Miss Bennett. She knows this jail as well as any of us.
But where is she?
I've no idea.
Oh, excuse me, can you get out of the way?
Well, maybe I could give you a hand, but it looks a bit heavier.
Thank you.
Here, could you take... where do you want them?
Just over there.
Right. Thanks.
Are you an artist or something?
No, I'm a student of botany at the university.
Oh, botany, that's plants, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, could I have my book, please? Oh.
Sorry.
Not very good sketches.
Oh, no, they're good.
Thanks. Are there any more sacks?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe I could give you a hand to carry some.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, a bit of exercise, you know.
Thanks. Does Mr. Butterfield always let you wander around like this?
Oh, actually, I'm his son, Jeff.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Do you work here now?
Yes, I'm Lynn. Lynn Warner.
Lynn. Oh, Lynn. Good day, Geoffrey.
Dad.
Where'd you put those clippers?
Well, aren't they in the shed?
Oh, they seem to have gone walkabout. Here, you put that down, Geoffrey. I'm paying her.
Here. Thanks. See you later.
Yeah. Maybe.
You're a bit rough on her, weren't you, Dad?
She's here to work, son, not stand around gas-bagging to university students.
Yeah, but still.
You got the afternoon off.
That'll be the day.
What have you been looking at?
Yeah.
Oh, you do a nice drawing, Geoffrey. Come down here. I've got some eucalyptus nicolai to show you.
How long's she been working here, Dad?
Oh, a while.
What do you mean you don't know where she is? Somebody must have seen her.
Why didn't you give her one?
Never had the chance. Alice and Madge said they saw her running, but they lost her. Anyway, where were you when we needed you?
I'm in enough trouble of my own.
And you'll be in more, Anderson, if you don't shut up.
Uh-oh. Mrs. Jackson.
What?
How's B?
We haven't heard yet.
She going to be all right?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't have slammed that Yates. I bet you got her in the pound, eh?
It's none of your damn business, Ferguson.
Well, well, well. Looks as if Yatesy's done a bunk. Even the screws don't know where she is.
Oh, Geoffrey, why don't you come home early from the uni tonight? We'll have a bit of a feed.
Yeah. No, I've got a couple essays to write.
Of course you have, and you'll do them too. Are you getting any exercise?
Oh, a bit flat out keeping up with the work.
Oh, well, you please yourself. Oh, hello, Lynn. You're off now, are you?
Yeah, I've got to catch the bus.
Righty-o. See you tomorrow.
Fine. Bye.
Oh, Lynn, which way are you going? I've got the car out front.
Oh, no, it'll be all right. It's an awfully long way. Bye.
I wouldn't have minded.
Oh, she'll be all right, son. She'll get where she's going. Like the look of her, do you?
Oh, yeah, she seems quite nice.
Yeah, she's not bad looking, I'll grant you. Well, you stick to the girls at your university, eh?
Them. Well, what's wrong with her?
Nothing. Forget it. I'm going to turn the sprinklers on.
Look, you're telling me to stay away from her. I mean, what's the reason? Is she married?
She used to be. She's a widow, not your type.
Why?
Look, Geoffrey, don't be a pest. Just leave it. Look, I'm telling you for your own good. She'll come good one day, but she's got to work things out and do her time.
Hey?
Look, son, she's a crim. Yes, she comes and works all day here and then goes back to the jug every night. She's doing 12 months for armed hold-up.
Armed hold-up? Her?
Yeah, she drove the car. Now, have you got all you want to know?
Been in there since the place was built.
I've had people on the roofs, the air conditioning, the pantries, nothing.
Not a trace.